Hey guys, it's Tuesday, April 11th, 2023. Today's going to be a 20-minute Navy SEAL session. I'm going to stick with the trying to knock off time each minute. 5 reps a minute is the sort of the format. You know, obviously it's not exactly 5 reps a minute because I'm shaving time off, but that's what I keep in mind. That's what helps keep me on track for getting that baseline 100 reps and then what I can do over. Now last session, I front loaded at the beginning with 7 reps for the first minute, and then right into fives, shaving off a second here, 5 seconds there. I ended up having about a minute and 20 seconds left, which gave me a good 15 second break, shaking my hands out, catching my breath, and then diving right in for a 7 rep finish. Today, I'm going to stick with the front loading. I'm going to do another 7 reps for the first minute, and then I'm going to see how 6 reps for the second minute feels, and then straight to fives. What I want to do is start shaving off that time right after that 6 minutes. So I'm cutting off a little more with the each 5 reps that I perform. So that's the plan. It's laid out. Let's see how it works. I'm going to do some chins and pull-ups or dips after my burpees. This has been a fun approach so far. Mentally easier. That could be, you know, because I was slaving away with the every minute on the minute approach for quite some time. Or maybe it's just easier. I don't know. 20 seconds. So I got 7 reps, 6 reps, 5s all the way through until the end, whatever time I can save up. Ideally, I like to save up enough time to get 7 reps. Here we go. Six. Seven. Oof. Five. What? Oof.
8.
Something's stuck in my mouth, on my lip. Not at 11. Reloaded in the front end. 7, 6. And then 8 at the end. Next goal will either be load another rep on the front end, by 7-6-6 or 7-7. I'm thinking I might do another 6 before I shoot for another 7. 1 minute of 7 is okay. Easy. I got a breath of rest left in me. 2 minutes is a little different story. Still doable, but I have to be concerned. Not concerned. I have to be mindful of 18 minutes that's going to follow those 2 minutes. And those 18 minutes have a goal to be done 5 reps a minute quickly, saving up time. I had about 1 minute and 23 seconds left. at the end. And I took about 10 seconds. No, I took more than 10 seconds. It took about 15 seconds. I caught my breath. and then I went for it. I was concerned about that 8th rep, because I had about 6 seconds left. As you can tell, I finished my last pump right when I came off and I was just about to stand up. So it was on the line. When it's on the line, I count it. If I was, you know, if it was a serious type of, if I was going for the busy dad standard, if I was going for graduation, I wouldn't count it. But it counts for today. All right, I got some dips, I got some chin-ups I wanted to do. It's been a while, since I've done chins. I was feeling my chest. Not exactly sure why. My last Navy SEAL session, 2 days ago, it wasn't a dip. It was a overhead press day. So I really, by all rights, should be feeling my shoulders more than my chest. But I could feel a fairly deep fatigue in my chest, even my first few reps of my Navy SEALs. So I'm thinking 3 sets, 5 chins, probably 5 weighted dips, 10 pounds, because that's what I got on there. Thank you. time between each. I really got to change out my burpee mat. I got hole wearing thin up here. I got a couple holes here and it's wearing thin in the back. Haven't even been using this for a year. But I do a lot of burpees every day. Easy. Trying to be explosive versus getting a ton of reps. Man, the temptation to grab a sip of water, especially before I started my last sprint, just to ease the ability to swallow, but I didn't want to do anything that might throw me off course. And the thing with the water, it might help, it also might not help. I'm getting the reps, so my ultimate thinking at the end is, why chance it for something that may inhibit the reps? Inhibit. Real good. Set two. So they chins are inspired by Lee Hazard. He did a video on weighted calisthenics with chins and dips being key. Obviously my chins aren't being weighted right now. I'm gonna, I think, cycle my pull-up ladders, my weighted pull-up ladder. Might not always be a ladder. I might do, you know, weighted sets of low reps, pull-ups, chin-ups, and then a weighted set of chin-ups. And then just keep working through this 4-movement cycles each time. Easier than the last set, and I'm getting lots of rest. One more round. Thought I might be sore from the 5-minute snatch set yesterday. And I feel my triceps, surprisingly, not surprisingly, I'm getting a lot of overhead rest. So the triceps are being worked, supportive role. My shoulders not so much. my lats, my mid back, a little sore. My traps, snatches really work the traps quite a bit. My biceps a little bit gripping, surprisingly. Snatches are a surprisingly good bicep exercise. Last set. Three sets of five. One more set of dips. Five, everything kept on the low end. Not pushing for reps. Not allowed to need to push for reps after I've already pushed for my Navy SEALs. Get this out of the way. So I'm actually going to have to organize this room because I got the squat racks coming up. Squat racks are mainly for my ex-wife who wants to start lifting a little heavier. She also wants to start racing again, getting in some distance, possibly 50Ks. Her best race has been 100K in a time race. Lots of 50s, tons of 50Ks. Time races were some of our favorite races to do together, and she would like to get a buckle. She'd like to get 100 miles, and I told her that I would come out of my racing retirement and help her. So she's toying with it. She'd start back slow, getting in some time races, getting in some 50Ks, some 50s. Lots of walking, lots of running. The great thing with ultras, it's finishing. Not how you finish, but finishing. So the squat rack's mainly for her, although I will probably eventually add in some squats, and I'm going to add in some overhead presses. This will save me from having to clean the weight from the floor. I just need to clear out some stuff that I'm not using, some kettlebells, my vertical rail bar, probably my parallette bars, and just get some room. So any suggestions on incorporating squats in my burpee routine, throw it out there. As well, it occurred to me just this morning that I talk a fair amount in these after workout talks. Whether it's worth anything or not, I don't know. It's just what actually happens, what's inspired and what comes out. Nothing's really planned. And I like it that way. I'm actually a fairly quiet person offline. My wife would argue that I'm fairly quiet to most people but her. And with her, I talk quite a bit, although I think I'm pretty quiet all the way around. But anyway, it occurred to me, you know, I throw out a lot of themes, meditation, breath work, cosmology. I talk about some science stuff, history,
all through the lens of my own understanding, nothing presented as if I'm teaching anything. I obviously can't teach cosmology. I can't teach quantum physics. I can teach meditation, and I can teach breath work. And I can also talk about the things that interest me through the lens of my own understanding, through the lens of my own awareness and self-understanding, and through a lens of non-duality inquiry. And I like to present it more as a discussion. With that in mind, does anyone wants me to introduce in a conversation to talk about together? I'm always more than open. If there's something I've talked about in the past, if you have questions on meditation, on breath work, on non-duality, and other things that we've discussed, just put it out there and we'll freeball it back and forth, however it comes out. I like to think of it as a dialogue. And the great thing with a dialogue is we go back and forth and we discover, we discover new things during the course of the dialogue. New things about ourselves, new things about each other, new things about that things that we thought we knew for certain. So basically, the dialogue is diving into mystery together. And really, you can have a dialogue with the universe. You can have a dialogue every morning. Spend a little time meditating, quieting the mind, and then just open up. Ask the world, ask nature, ask the universe, who am I? What am I? Where am I? And listen to how nature answers. Most often it's in silence, but sometimes it's in a language of bird calls, language of the wind, blowing through grass, rustling the trees. Who knows how it's going to be? But start that dialogue. Just start it with yourself and the universe and see what happens, see what responds. Start it with the beginning of your burpee set. How would I like this? Or even take yourself out of the equation. How should this burpee session unfold? How should this pull-up session unfold? Don't always have to have a set plan, or better yet, work within the perimeters of that set plan. 20 minutes doing this, but how is each rep going to arise in its own unique, special way? And just be mindful of how it happens and what it's telling you and how to proceed from that moment on. So basically, it's all a dialogue. It's a dialogue now, me opening up to you guys and however you respond. The dialogue of me and my burpee session, the dialogue of me and my walk this morning, and the dialogue of my upcoming run that I'm going to do in just a few minutes. So let me say goodbye, and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Take care.